Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Ravenloft Stone Prophet. In today's episode, we are going to continue exploring the Sphinx. I believe that's where we left off. So we're just going to jump right in, as per usual, and start cutting down everything that stands in our way. Let's see, where haven't we been? Looks like we are heading... we're going to pop around and check out over here, and then we're probably going to come back and clear out this before we start heading south. And what do I have on the floor in here? Probably a scroll or something. Oh, that's that stupid ring of wizardry. That's right, we got gold leaf down to a ridiculous negative 5 armor class. I wonder if they actually respect the cap to it in this. I know in normal second edition, you're typically kept to about a negative 10. I think you can get... at the highest, you're allowed a negative 12, and I don't know if players are actually allowed that. I know some of the older dragons have ACs of that level, but as well, that's something player characters aren't allowed. I know in Menzo Barons, and I think the highest you could get was like a negative 8 or 9, barring doing cheesy crap. But I'd assume you can go higher in this because it's a you go to higher levels and stuff. Come on, let me move. Move. Okay.
As it is written, as it has been foretold, I hold a secret. A word of command is mine to tell. Listen, for the history of Octopod belongs to he who speaks the name Hierophant.
All right. We know the word, Hierophant, and we mustn't forget it. I of course get the trapped one. And that one of course has nothing in it. Beautiful, if typical. Ow. And I'm gonna eat another one. Alright, we're gonna try resting here. Yes. Okay. There were items back there. God damn it! Now, I'd just ignore them, but knowing my luck, they're probably like. Dayern's Instant Awesome. Or Potions of Extra Healing. Oh my god! Into random boxes they go. Oh no. Jeez. I could use, like, I don't know, 3 more boxes, maybe? 3 more, I think, and I'd be able to clean up pretty good. Okay, what do we got up here? A magic missile spell. To the face. I don't remember if we've got that key or not. We do. Alright. Gold key with blue gem. That's a trap! Oh my god. Get... no! Die! I think we have one on the side of us, too. Or behind... you obnoxious creature. Die! Jesus gods, I hate those things. What's in this thing? Did we get anything? No. That's nice. Okay, we have a way over here. See, if I play my cards right, I can kill them before they hit us. And they're pretty decent XP. My god, Piotr's already 10th level. Admittedly, thieves are the quickest leveling class in the game. But damn! Okay then. Of course. No, not that. Back in your goopy cage, you creepy little mimic thing. Okay. I'll head over this way. No. wasn't a button, was it? No. Wait. Oh. Okay. It is down here. A locked door. What else? Don't jump out at people like that, it's rude. Okay.
I shall reveal nothing to you, for you are nothing to me. Hurry on! Away now!
Okay. Jerk. Oh yeah. Alright, we'll get this once we come around, so we're not gonna worry about it for now. However... Oh yeah. Get off there. Key. Seriously, game, I appreciate the thought, but, quit it. We'll drop the, javelins of lightning, because I'm never gonna use these stupid things. Got lucky with that one. Ha! No. No pushy thing. I want my gauntlets of giant strength. Damn it. Where's Swell's 22 strength score? Okay, see, now I wonder what's in there. Arrgh, god dang it. Mad dash, mad dash, mad dash, mad dash, mad dash, mad dash. No. I gotta be such a jerk. And I totally didn't just do that just so I had an excuse to use some of these Kayaktop ointments. No. Would never have done that. The dreams of Octopot. In these days, mothers frighten their children with tales of Octopot. They say he stalks the night, a mummy wandering the desert sands. It is a tale for children. The truth of it is worse. A reality of dreams and the fitful state in which a monster sleeps. All mummies are prone to long periods of slumber, and Octopot is no exception. According to the most reliable sources, he lies sealed in Pharaoh's rest, in a state similar to the empiric hibernation. His mind has entered a dreamlike state. Unfortunately, the powers of Octopod are so great that his dreams alone affect the land. It is said of storms, disease, and disasters in Harakir that they are the wrath of the dreaming Octopod. What a jerk. Hey! I didn't even step on it. Alright, where's the button? Okay, I'll admit, that time I... Oh, it wasn't... Gotcha. Alright, and that just opens up. Okay, I think we'll... Of course! Of friggin' course I'm stuck. No. There we go. Let's see what we have around here. Alright, having gotten stuck, I'm going to save, just for posterity's sake here. There. Okay, what do we got here? Octopot's touch of death. I am much worried over the health of my Lord Octopot. Each breath comes as a distraction, as though he fears it might be his last. His search to extend his life consumes him. The palace has become silent, and within its walls we walk about as in a tomb. The music once played is gone. It is said the priests of Ra no longer trust my lord. War, a series of deaths has begun among them. How can they blame my dear lord, my suffering lord? They call it Octopot's touch of death. Were it in my power, I would punish them for such insolence. Were it in my power, I would heal my lord Octopot of all misery. Thankfully, it's not in your power, and you died behind a table. Ow! Okay... explored the area. Sounds good to me. Okay. We're gonna eat another one, I'm sure, yes. Come around, alright. We're just gonna rest. Cause Piotr's getting low on the HPs there. Come around. Of course I took a wrong turn. We're gonna go this way. Damn it. Not this way. No. Oh my god, how did I? Oh damn it. Note to Gene, pay attention to your damn map instead of just glancing at it offhandedly. No. Looks like we're gonna have to run through this. God. Eat it. Eat it! All of you, eat! Ow. See, and I want to check. Okay, there's where we came in. Map note. There. Came in. Okay, turn that off. Is there a way down over here? Yes, haha! I was trying to remember whether or not there was actually a second floor to the place and was kind of hoping that it was near the entrance so we wouldn't have to spend 4 hours looking for it. Down we go! Level 2! Fight! I've killed ancient mummies with more hit points than you guys! Alright. Illusionary wall, another stairs down. Stairs down that weren't stairs down, but an illu- If there's a way to communicate with this presence, then we've not yet found it. I don't know. Senior statue looks talkative. There's something about this figure, an animation, a power held in check, but barely so. If it would speak. Can you hear us? That's not creepy. I stab it with my sword. It is ineffective. Oh yeah! Down further we go.
You have entered the labyrinth of the Magi. Priests and mages, the wise and the powerful have known this place. Held safe within, their secrets await study.
Labyrinth, eh? Are there minotaurs within the labyrinth? I'm gonna just guess that this whole hallway is nothing but stuff like that, so we're just gonna dash through and likely miss secrets and stuff. Alright. Door. I wanna say that looks kinda bluish. Okay, it's like. That is like so, like, slate blue. Piotr, do your job. With pleasure, my lord. Alright, what do we got here? The nature of Ra. Pharaoh to the gods, by this name Ra is known, and also by his light. It is the brilliance of the desert sun. He rides the air in a war galley, one made in part from the sun, and which is called Matet. The light of day, the truth, the good, these are but a few of the marvels for which he is known. The praise of the growing fields belongs to Ra, and is said no magic can affect him. Though the gods of evil and those of good find themselves in conflict, Ra will not permit them to go to war. Open battle among them is forbidden. It is the influence of Ra which allows a measure of goodness to survive in Harakir. Okay. One, two, three, four, five, six. Okay. Oh, an arrow made out of rocks. It was a trap. I should have known better than to trust rock arrows. Here, come get me, you stupid thing, and eat a fireball while you're at it. Or don't. I think that actually did open a way, though. It did. It also triggered the spazzy fireball traps of doom. Oh my god. I know what this means. Bees! Yes, nature's little death. Die from the bees! Oh god, one survived! Get out of the bees, you idiots! Why are you standing in the bees, Swell?
I like how it feels when they sting me.
Gold whistle. Oh, okay. Thought we already had one of those, but okay. We do now! You can't see it, but I'm shaking my fist at the screen. And we're not gonna rest. We have healing. And Swell can lay on hands. Okay, wait. Ooh, there's something back there. Damned if I know who, though. Let's see what we have back here. No! Oh my god! Yeah. Get out of my face! Okay, we got a button. That I shall, of course, press. And another button. That I shall also press. In the back of the party with that two-handed sword. Hey, no mimic. Sweet. Crocodile figurine. I'm honestly... That was like... Bad game designers for making it the exact same color as the floor. I'm glad I even thought to look to see if anything dropped out of that. Okay, honestly, that's it for back here. Yes, okay. Through the poisony doom. Yaddy yaddy yaddy. And run! Okay, and then we'll go all the way back. And...
An offering I await. Approach and deliver to me the likeness of a creature. In life, it draws its prey beneath the waves, there to die. The armored lord of the riverbanks.
I wonder what that could be. Clearly the golden whistle.
The offering is true.
I'm throwing Mr. Pointy at you. Okay, looks like we got three critter beasts ahead. No, yes, there. Yeah, thread, come, fight me.
Wah, through the bees!
Darn it.
Sounds like I like when they sting me in the face.
Okay, no apparent way to open that door, or that door, or that door, or that door, or that door. Mm-hmm. fire burning in the corner of the room. Interesting. Alright, let's see what this talky thing down here wants. I assume it's yes.
An offering I await. Approach and deliver to me the likeness of a creature. In life it strikes with horned fury, the lord of the gate smashers.
Horned fury, the lord of the gate smashers, a bull, perhaps? Alright, we're gonna head straight back this way. I think this is the stairs. Yes, I have an idea. We're going to employ the whistle on this thing. Hey, creepy statue lady thing. Obnoxious ringing! Nope. I tried. Figured I'd look. Back down we go. Back into the salt mines! Okay, we're basically kind of just gonna poke around a little bit. Ooh, clever. Okay, so we got, save game point. Alright, we'll go through this one. Well, hello there, Mr. Large Hikaro Sphinx. Hikaro Sphinx. And I think, god dang it! And I think we have another one chewing on the back of the car. Yes. Look at that. It's rude to chew on the back of the party. They have low armor classes and are weak. And not looking like a whole lot in here. Of course. Alright. And I'm oh my god, there's another one. What if that's a button? But I can't move to push it. Haha! I'm going to go ahead and just assume that that opened another door. And it did. However, Soul's going to lay on hands. And we're going to try and inch around this corner to this portal. Okay, you see, I don't like this, and we'll take the right one because right is always wrong. Of course. Okay, so let's try this again. Straight through. Left portal. Button. And a bunch of pots. Haste. Quick. Back in your hole! Oh god! I like that one only had like 5 hit points. Somebody got gypped on the hit die rolls. Okay then. Back to the main area? No. Now back to the main area. Okay, and I got 2 more doors open, so we'll hit this one right here. Pull around, because I think we have one on our butt. Yes. Alright, and it's X-Form. This spell is so overpowered. Why don't they give us Blade Barrier? Blade Barrier would be entertaining. God damn it! Please! Alright, not looking like any, buttons in here. We'll take the right one. I think we have been returned to an area we've already been, so left one? Yes. And here. Okay. So we'll jump in here. Okay, this time left one. Alright, so nothing in there. like it's really hard to tell if these are new rooms. Right one. This is a new room, though. Okay. Not even falling for it. You guys can't hear, but there's totally an angelic chorus going right now. Okay. So it's bag holding, so that means you should have like little arrows at the bottom with like a bajillion pages. Stupid Kiog Tom's going to get out of here. And he needs the AC, so I'm going to keep him holding that shield. Yay! Here, Piotra, you can hold some cure potions too. They look so. Actually, you know what? No, I'm getting rid of these stupid things because I can't figure out how to use them, and goddammit, and I'm lazy. So, yeah. There. We now have another box. And this can go into Swell's inventory. Okay. Buttons, buttons, buttons. The invisible. Take the right one. New one? Yes? See. Aha, frog figurine. See, we've gotta break them because I actually just realized that after we skipped one of the last one. They'll probably have these goddamn figurines in them that we need. So that means I'm probably gonna have to go back through that other one as well. This one looks to be one that I've already been in. That was nice and pointless there. Okay. I think it was this one where I skipped one. And it was left portal. Or not. I hate puzzles like these. They're frustrating. Great water. Screw you, game. Okay, not seen anything. Not seen anything. Alright, we'll go try this one at the little puzzle person thing. Hail, puzzle person thing of great and mighty value. We got a froggy.
The offering is false.
Ah!
The offering.
That means it isn't one of those damnable things. Okay, we'll go through here. And the right one, and here we are. A ram! Oh, and they're even conveniently color-coded. That's nice, I guess. Away. Organizing.
The offering.
Yeah, I know. I'm gonna assume you're down here. Yeah. Eat sharp, pointy objects. Okay, so our next thing's gonna be blue, and I'm gonna assume that the frog's gonna go to open this. Let's see what he's got to
say. An offering I await. Approach and deliver to me the likeness of a creature. In life, legless it begins, rising from the water to leap among the low places, from fish to webbed feet in a cycle of the moon.
Oh.
The offering is true.
Okay, so we have poison death wall to our left, a brick of Sphinx to our left, poison death wall to our right. We know two directions, good. Let's see, we have a long haul. You're also at 30 minutes, so I'm gonna save. And I think I'm gonna call it an episode here, folks. So, as per usual, thanks for watching, and I will see you all next time.